Morning. Today now we are going to see about the experimental proof of DNA replication. DNA replication is said the semi-conservative DNA replication. It is most acceptable, and experimental proof was given by Michelson and Stahl in the year 1958. The mode of DNA replication. The experimental proof was given by scientists called Michelson and Stahl experiment. In the year 1958, here I just explain inside also. This is the DNA which is labeled with heavy isotope nitrogen 15, and it undergoes DNA replication after 20 minutes. You can see it's a parental strand. Each parental strand, the red color, it can produce a complementary new daughter strand, and you can see that new strand is labeled with nitrogen 14. That is the common nitrogen source. It is nitrogen 14 is a light isotope. Nitrogen 15, red color, is a heavy isotope. That blue color is nitrogen 14. DNA, two strands like this intermediate strand is formed. When after 20 minutes, that is after 40 minutes, you can see in the F2 generation or in the second generation, the two it divides and produce four DNA strands. And here you can see that is nitrogen 14 DNA it is formed. This is called nitrogen 14 normal DNA with the light isotope. That means its density is very less. And two intermediate strands are there, and these two are, one is the red color is nitrogen 15 heavy isotope, and that blue color is nitrogen 14 labeled DNA. Like this, they form the different band, color band. Nitrogen 15 heavy isotope, it forms the red color, and nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 15 hybrid newly formed DNA strand, it forms intermediate color like brown color. And here you can see two bands are formed. One is intermediate, another one is only the light isotope, that is nitrogen 14. Nitrogen 14 is there, it's very less dense, so it remains on the top of the tube, test tube. And you can see intermediate, it's remaining in the intermediate, and you can see that is light brown in color. So we'll see this experiment one by one now. Now, Michelson and Stahl, they proved the semi-conservative DNA replication. And this semi-conservative DNA replication was proposed by the famous scientist called, who are they? Watson and Crick. So what is semi-conservative DNA replication? The DNA is a double helical strand, and during replication, the two strands, they unwind or separate. And both the parental strand, when they separate at a particular point, one parental strand acts as template, and they synthesize a new daughter strand is synthesized, which is having complementary base pairs to the parental strand. So like this, two daughter strands are formed. The two daughter strand, they have one parental strand and another one is new daughter strand. So that's why they retain or conserve only half of the parental strand. That's why it's called as semi-conservative. Half of the parental character is conserved. So it's called as semi-conservative DNA replication. Now we'll see the experimental proof for the semi-conservative mode of DNA replication. Okay. Who proposed and proved this experiment? The scientist called Michelson and Stahl. And this experiment in the year in 1958. So for that, they cultured the bacterium E. coli are grown in separate media for many generations. Okay, E. coli, they can multiply within 20 minutes. They can produce its new replicator cells. DNAs are produced. So two cultures of E. coli are grown in separate media. One media containing the heavy isotopes nitrogen 15 as the nitrogen source. Another media containing the normal isotope or light isotope containing nitrogen 14. So one culture is called as heavy culture, in which the medium contains the ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is nothing but the nitrogen source. The heavy isotope is represented by N nitrogen 15. Another culture, it's called as light culture, in which the medium contains the ammonium chloride with light isotope of nitrogen, that is nitrogen 14. So keep in your mind nitrogen 15 is heavy isotope culture, heavy culture, E. coli, and nitrogen 14 is called light culture, E. coli. Okay. Now the bacterial DNA grown in heavy culture, we are extracting the DNA from the culture medium, and the DNA consists of mainly nitrogen 15 in heavy culture and nitrogen 14 in the light culture. So DNA consists of nitrogen 15 in heavy culture, nitrogen 14 in light culture. The heavy and light DNA has to be separated, or it can be distinguished by a technique called cesium chloride density gradient centrifugation technique. So heavy and light DNA. So N15 is heavy DNA, N14, nitrogen 14 is light DNA. Both are separated or distinguished by what is the technique called? Cesium chloride, CSCL, cesium chloride density gradient centrifugation technique. So both the DNAs, there is nitrogen 14 DNA and nitrogen 15 DNA. Heavy isotope DNA is separated from normal isotope DNA, and they form two distinct separate band. Already I showed. Okay, two bands are formed. Now the heavy culture nitrogen 15, it was then transformed into the medium containing normal ammonium chloride containing culture. And now the samples, once again, they were taken at various time interval. For every 20 minutes, the samples containing DNA was collected and observed for their light and heavy isotopes. Clear, ma? Now, what is this basic? The E. coli is cultured into separate media. And here you can see that is nitrogen 15 DNA, that is heavy isotope. Another one is nitrogen 14 DNA, it's also cultured. After 20 minutes, both are cultured in separate culture medium, and this nitrogen 15 DNA, it replicate and produce, this is a parental strand, consists of heavy isotope, and newly formed, that is another newly formed nitrogen 14 DNA, that is formed in the first generation or second generation after 20 minutes. So here, because of these two strands, red and blue color mix, and they produce hybrid, that is nitrogen 14, nitrogen 15 as an intermediate color, and the band is formed in the intermediate position. But here the nitrogen 15 or heavy isotope DNA is more denser. So it is present at the bottom of the centrifugation tube. Nitrogen 15, nitrogen 15 is a heavy isotope, that's why it's present in the lower portion of the centrifugation tube. Okay, once again it is allowed to replicate. After 40 minutes, if you collect in the second generation, you can get two different bands. What are they? One is in the intermediate portion, that is nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 15 hybrid DNA, and another one is the light isotope, nitrogen 14, nitrogen 14 DNA strands are collected. So like this, one can replicate into two, and this is the intermediate, it shows the semi-conservative DNA replication. One is red color is parental, this is new daughter strand. And in the second generation, once again it's allowed to replicate, means, and once again the semi-conservative DNA replication and new and parental strands are formed. Two strands are formed, two bands are formed. One is the light isotope nitrogen 14 on the upper portion of this centrifugation tube, and in the intermediate portion, nitrogen 14, nitrogen 15 band, that is brown color band is formed. Okay. Now this is blue color, nitrogen 14 is a blue color. After the first replication here, okay, after 20 minutes, the DNA is extracted and centrifuged. Okay, it is allowed to rotate in the centrifuge machine, and only one band is formed. It was in intermediate position between the, here you can see one band is formed as the intermediate position, and which is having both the heavy and light bands. After the second replication, this is the second generation or second replication, once again the DNA is extracted and centrifuged, and now the DNA forms two bands, one nearer to light band position. Light band means what is the isotope, ma? Nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 14 DNA extracted consists of the light isotope. Another one is intermediate band, you can see this is nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 15, that is intermediate band. So this result confirms the semi-conservative mode of replication of DNA by Watson and Crick. And all these, we have studied cesium chloride density gradient technique, we are going to see as an animation video. Video, it will explain to you how it grows. Now, Michelson and Stahl experiment, you can see. Now, this is, they provide, Michelson and Stahl experiment provide evidence of semi-conservative DNA replication. The bacterium is cultured here in the culture medium containing heavy isotope nitrogen 15 medium. Okay, it is allowed to replicate. So the bacterial E. coli cells, they replicate again and again, 1 into 2, 2 into 4 like this. But they contain, the DNA is extracted, contain nitrogen 15 only, heavy isotope only they contain. It is transferred into another culture medium containing normal ammonium chloride, that is nitrogen 14 medium. And here, if it is allowed to replicate and they are collected, harvested DNA cells, bacterial cells containing DNA is kept in cesium chloride solution. Now, it is kept in the cesium chloride density gradient, allowed to centrifuge at a high speed. Okay, in the high speed, you can get the, after this separation of the DNA strands in different bands, okay, the DNA containing nitrogen 14, it is a light isotope, remain on the topmost position. Okay, because it's a light isotope, it occupies nitrogen 15 isotope DNA, it is present in the lower portion, is a density, it is denser band it forms. And after, in the first generation or F1 generation of DNA replication, intermediate band is formed, which contain one strand is nitrogen 14, another strand is nitrogen 15. Okay, allowed to replicate. After 40 minutes or F2 generation, you can see there are two bands. This is one band, here two bands are formed. One is in the intermediate band, F2 generation. One is intermediate band, N14 and N15. Another one is the normal band, nitrogen 14. It proves Michelson and Stahl experiment, the DNA replication is semi-conservative replication as such by Watson and Crick, which contain half nitrogen 15, half nitrogen 14 mediate, intermediate, and one is half nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 14 half. You can see this experiment proves the Watson and Crick DNA replication. Is it clear? Yes. Thank you.